today's gospel is part of a longer passage from John in which Jesus refers to himself as the Good Shepherd. The sheep trust the Good Shepherd, and they will run from the voice of strangers, but the voice of the shepherd they will follow. And they follow him because they know his voice. But voices come from all sides, sending this fundamental message that we are not enough if we don't have and do all the right things which measure success. That's our culture. It's that theology which claims that failure is a sign of sin, and failure is the consequence of falling out of favor with God. Success is a sign of clean living and God's favor. So I'm mindful as we journey through this season of Easter that the dynamic of the Christian life is not success and failure. It is death and resurrection. Gospel proclaims what God does. Gospel proclaims a dynamic of dying and rising, that through the power of God's love, God can raise anyone to new life. Voice of the shepherd. I would suggest a different voice from the predominant cultural voice. If we recall the voice from heaven at the baptism of our Lord, the voice proclaims, "You are my beloved Son, with whom I am well pleased." That voice says what is true all along about Jesus, a proclamation made before Jesus accomplishes one thing in his public ministry. And it is a proclamation to be heard at every baptism, not just the baptism of our Lord. True all along for everyone baptized, "You are my beloved child. With you I am well pleased." Before you accomplish one thing in life, you are someone who counts already. Everyone is a child of God. Everyone. And everyone is of no less value to God than Jesus himself. Will this baptismal candidate, will this confirmation candidate hear from us the voice of the Good Shepherd? Will we communicate to her or to him their fundamental value? Will we teach them and show them with our lives that they can trust the shepherd? Will we show them with our lives which voice to follow? For we can trust the Good Shepherd. He walks with us through the valley. He seeks us when we are lost. We belong to him. He says, "You are my beloved child." That's the voice of the Good Shepherd. That's the voice we follow and proclaim. All in the name of the Holy Trinity, one God in whom we live and move and have our being.